Well, here it is Monday. And after our worship time as a church family yesterday, I think we need to look at how folks around us will know we are part of the family of God and that we are part of a church family. John 13:35. By this all men will know that you are my disciples if you love and have love for one another. When we accept Christ and become Christians, we are born by and through the power of God. And we are given, like we talked about all the in part of last week, about loving in a Christ-like way. But we're told that they and the world recognizes us by how we love each other. How do we know if someone's a disciple of Christ? We're told of the telltale signs, and that is if you love one another. It starts in the church. Love one another. We're reborn as a new creature, and as such, we have a new godly nature. And that places us in the family of God, having brothers and sisters. Now, I don't always get along with my brothers and my sister. We don't always have the best of relationships, maybe because of distance and because of just not spending time together. But there's no doubt we love each other. So when everything is said and done, we're to show our love for our brothers and sisters in Christ in a Christ-like way. It all starts with our brothers and sisters in Christ and works out into the world. If you can't love people of the family of God, how are you going to love people into the family of God that aren't the family of God? Love is a powerful thing. You can love someone into the family of God. You can love somebody in the family of God and help them grow and mature. Love is a wonderful, wonderful thing when lived to the glory of God. If we are born of God and have become partakers of His divine nature, love will automatically be in our hearts because God is love. If you're in Christ and Christ is in you, don't stifle, don't shove down the way God tells you to love and the way God shows you to love with a new heart and a new life as a new creature. Love the way Christ loves and the way Christ teaches you to. Open the Word of God and learn how Christ loves so that you can love like Christ. Let Christ lead you in His Word on what is healthy love and what is not healthy love. A lot of God's people are living unhealthy love. You need to make sure by the Word of God you are living the way Christ wants you to live. To be God's child is to share God's nature. You automatically have the love in you. You just need to nurture it and let it grow. And you need to nurture it through and by reading the Bible, the Word of God. We don't need a bumper sticker or a lapel pin to prove that we are Christians. It should be evident by how we love those around us. And even the love of unlovable. And not just those in the church, but those out of the church and those you work with, and those you have contact with. Love is the very nature of God, and therefore it is a characteristic of His children. Are you living to learn? Living and learning the characteristic of love? Are you loving those around you in a way that glorifies God? There's somebody out there that needs for you to touch them in the name of Jesus. Love them in the name of Jesus. Go get them. Go love them. Dear gracious Heavenly Father, thank you for loving us first. Thank you for loving us while we were yet sinners so that we can love those that are sinners around us as well. Please, Lord, let us love in a way that glorifies you. In Jesus' name we pray.